Well, guys, there's been a change of plans for the 67. I know I'd originally planned on building a long bed, mostly stock restoration truck with this drive. I have figured out that I'm pretty sure that most everything I'm going to need for the... Hold on, I got to put the camera. Most everything I'm going to need to run power steering on this motor in AC, I'm pretty sure none of it mounts to the heads. And I'm pretty sure that if any of it does mount to the heads, I can drill them. So I don't think that's going to be a problem. We're looking at our Corvette, our 73 Vet, and it's got a 350 in it, and it's got power steering AC, obviously. And neither of those mount to the heads. The heads aren't even drilled in it. So, we'll see. But this right here is a 69 model. Short bed, originally step side, C10 chassis with power steering. We went and picked it up maybe a week and a half ago, rolling chassis, and had that cab on it. Well, dude wants the cab back. We paid $500 for it. Original tie rod ends. So you know it's never really been worked on. Some idiot tried to repaint it, but I took the rear suspension out of it, sitting over there. And I got these tires back here, one to hold up, 1 foot weight on it so the front end don't flip up. But fixing to start stripping the front end down. And what we're gonna do is I know we're gonna sandblast the long bed frame that we had that we stripped down, because it has so much surface rust. But this one, I think we're just gonna take a DA and hit it. As you can see, I've already hit the DA on it in a couple of spots. There's one, I don't know if you can see that one, but it has an automatic cross member in it. It's bolted in, so I think this was originally a manual transmission truck. So I think what we'll do is I'll take that out and put the 3-speed manual cross member in there, because they're different, because the automatic obviously mounts in the center and the manual has two mounts on the sides. So we'll see. Something I'm confused about, and I haven't really researched this much, but on the 68 frame I have, the radiator support mounts, the holes are smaller. They're a lot smaller than these. I don't know if the 69 radiator support requires a bigger mount or what, but I don't know. Leave your suggestions about it, please. I got to figure that out. So I don't know. I'll probably look in some catalogs and see if there's a difference in the core supports and do some research. But the 67 here, that tire right there and identical to it on the other side were on the front of that chassis because they hold there. They're the only two that came on that hold there, so I just threw them on here yesterday. That one's off the long bed chassis, the only one that holds air. So now it's only got one rally on it. actually that's not the rally I want to have on it. It's not the one that holds air. No, there's one tire on it now that doesn't hold air. And this one here, have another one, but this one's seized to the hub and brake drum. It did that the first time I tried to pull it, so it's still like that. But I'll show you guys the long bed chassis that I will eventually be selling. It is completely stripped down. That's not the rear end and everything that goes to it. That rear end came out of the short bed. But this one right here, I mean, it has tons of surface rust on it. And we were just going to have it sandblasted just for the sake of having it sandblasted, not have to worry with it. But since we decided to make a short bed, and rather than cut this one down, since we ran across that one so quickly, only a few days after we decided, we figured, heck, you can go buy it. You know, all the suspension there is there. It's a rolling chassis, $500. You know, cash, change some hands, and just sit in our driveway. This is the front suspension off the long bed. We don't know if we're going to be using any of this on the short bed or not. So this is the rear end out of the long bed. 12 bolt open diff. Don't know what gears. Let's see. That's the transmission out of it. And there's the trailing arms and rear bumper off of it. We're going to reuse these trailing arms because these trailing arms here, I don't know if I'll be able to show you without flipping it over, but are extremely rusted out. I mean, you say they're not supposed to separate that much, I don't believe, but on the other side, they're really a lot worse. But this is a 12-bolt open diff too, so we won't be reusing these trailing arms. We will reuse the coil springs, and that's about it. And probably one of those tires I'll end up painting gloss black. I mean, the wheels end up painting gloss black, put a new tire on it, and that'll be my spare. I don't know what wheels we're going to run yet, but 067 still cranking up fine. So here in the next couple of weeks, it won't be running anymore for about another year, because I got to pull the front clip off, figure out what I'm going to use, get the motor and drivetrain off, get the cab off so we can do the body work and the rockers and the cab corners on it. And so not much longer will it be a long wheelbase green 67. It's still going to be a 67, but it's going to be a short bed. Possibly, I don't have a bed yet, so I don't know if I'm going to be running a short bed fleet side or short bed step side. I got to find one. Something I do want to point out to you, those of you who are building this, in 68, everybody knows that they put the marker lights in for the government regulations, like that one has. That's not a 67 bed. They also did something else. The fender here, this lip, is different than in 68. They changed the lip, as you can see here. Lip a lot smaller. So those of you that are building a 67 and plan to use 68 fenders with a 67 bed and just fill in the holes on the 68 fender, don't do it. You will realize how stupid you are if you get the bodywork done, trust me. Unless you realize it before, but more than likely you'll end up realizing after you get the bodywork done. So we're going to be using 68 fenders, so more than likely we'll find a 68 72 bed. So I'm just going to patch the holes up, say it's a 67, and people who are smart enough to realize the